the morning star, drive 117.8. You soaring up with sky, now's the time, don't delay. I'm sitting in my ride and it's time to fly. So let's realign, just listen and fill your mind.
I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head in the zone, you know. I'm on the morning star, drive, you know.
Hey guys, how's it going? It's Friday, July 23rd, and this is the Morning Star Drive on 117.8. We're on YouTube, so make sure to subscribe, follow us on SoundCloud, and make sure to support us on Patreon. So what is happening on this fabulous Friday? We'll get some coronavirus updates, current news from around the world, of course, a word study about the Wednesday message, and then back to the MBTI segment with Wonchan. All right, guys, how are you doing on this final day of the week? It is Friday. Finally, it has come, and I'm sure all of you are getting ready to enjoy a wonderful, wonderful weekend. I'm not sure what you guys have planned. What do I have planned, guys? Just the same old. I got Bible studies. I got to finish a Netflix series. Yeah, I got a bunch of stuff going on, but lately my lecture training has all finished. I was doing lecture training with a bunch of people over there in America. That is finally finished, and now I'm just wondering what I should be doing. Not really sure yet, but just super thankful that it is the weekend. Hope you guys are looking forward to some fun relaxation and, of course, the amazing Sunday service. All right, so let's get things kicked off here together on the Morning Star Drive, so keep listening, liking, and commenting. I want to hear from you guys and see how you're doing. Go ahead, post your song requests, questions, and stories too. Would love to hear how you guys are doing also in the comments. All right, let's go into... Oh, by the way, since we're doing a new direction in the YouTube channel, we will not be having a video today. So we usually have a Tuesday, Fridays, but we will be switching to... Right now, every Tuesday, it's just once a week, but we're going to make them a little bit better and a little bit more spiritual. All right, guys. Also, this Sunday edition, we're going to meet another member from America. It is Rose Lederman from Houston, Texas, over there in the U.S. She is running hard for this history. Great story. Amazing story. I was really shocked and surprised. I just didn't know that she was also someone who's evangelized in Japan. And I hope you guys really enjoy these Sunday edition interviews, just getting to meet each other in a more intimate way and kind of getting to see how we all came into this history. And this is obviously something I really did this for the sake of the future, where they'll be able to see what types of people were here during this time while Sunseem was living. All right, also Patreon, we have new videos each and every week, exclusively only for Patreon. There'll be word studies, there'll be Monday Zoom Bible studies. There are also going to be some mini newcomer Bible studies too. So, and if you guys have any other ideas, those of you on Patreon, just go ahead and leave a message below, and I'll definitely want to hear what else you guys want to listen, or what other content you want on the Patreon site. All right, so let's get into today's featured artist of the day on this fabulous Friday. On this fabulous Friday, what should we listen to? Let's start off with Juice Star Aiden Verity, and she's got that 90s pop groove, and I really like this song that she just, her latest single, Hot Guy in the Corner. And for those of you guys who don't know, when she explained what it was, this song is about that first burning love for the Lord and how it's like seeing that hot guy in the corner, that kind of feeling of love. So great song and great analogy too. The second song is The Sky from Japan with the song Home. And last but not least, we have Xeniac from PMA in Korea with the self-titled song Xeniac. All right, guys, as we're pushing ourselves even more and more into the final stages of the 70-day prayer condition, I hope that everyone will leave in a little prayer for these member artists from around the world.
To see, I'm starting to believe you might be what I need. Even in shadow, you look so nice. Can't wait to see you step into the bright lights.
Is it time?
seals, eyes are spinning wheels. How can I keep my chill when you give me all the feels? Is that a halo? Is that a crown? Look at you, look at me, look you up and down.
Yeah.
And there you go. That was Xeniac from PMA in Korea, and that song is a self-titled song, Xeniac. Before that, The Sky from Japan with the song Home, and the feature artist of the day was Juice Star Aiden Verity from New Zealand with Hot Guy in the Corner. All right, guys, so let's get into some news going on around the world on this last day of the week. Coronavirus updates, we have 192.8 million cases with 4.1 million deaths, and that's a 2.14% mortality rate. Now take a look at the top five countries, and what we're going to do is now we're only going to look at the daily infection rates and also how many daily deaths there were. So let's start off with the U.S. The U.S. is on top with 56,000 cases in a day. However, they only had 416 deaths, right? And remember, this is a population of like 350 million people. So that's actually pretty small. But second, so here's a comparison, guys. Brazil, 54,000 cases with 1,388 deaths in a single day, which is more than three times the amount of the U.S. with less infection rates. The U.K., 44,000 cases, only 73 deaths. India, 41,000 cases with 510 deaths. And then, of course, we have Indonesia, 33,000 cases, however, 1,383 deaths, right? So more than 20,000 less cases than Brazil, but only five less deaths in a single day. So that's pretty brutal what's going on over there in Indonesia. We could keep our prayers for all those people and our members that are living there at this time right now. Over here in Southeast Asia, of course, Indonesia, 33,000 cases, 1,383 deaths. And then we have Thailand in second with 13,000 cases, 108 deaths. Malaysia over here has 11,900 cases, 199 deaths. And then the Philippines with 6,500 cases with 32 deaths. So that's pretty good for the Philippines, only 32 deaths in a single day. All right, guys, let's get into the top three news for today. So what's going on around the world? We're going to start off with what's happening over there in South America, or we can say Latin America and the Caribbean, okay? So Pan America Health Organization says only 15% of people in Latin America and the Caribbean are fully vaccinated. Coronavirus infections are increasing across much of Central America and on smaller Caribbean islands. The Pan American Health Organization, which is the PAHO or PAHO, said on Wednesday, as it repeated a call for more vaccine donations to help hard-hit nations. Now, the PAHO director, Carissa Etienne, said while Uruguay, Chile, and Argentina, nations that have made considerable headway in their vaccine campaigns, are reporting steep declines in new infections, cases, and deaths, there's a spiking in Cuba, Honduras, and Guatemala. The Amazonian regions of Colombia and Peru also remain COVID-19 hotspots. And basically, she said that they face a pandemic of the unvaccinated, and the only way to stop it is to expand vaccination. And this is what's said during a weekly briefing, that vaccines are critical, even if no vaccine is 100% effective. So just only 15% of people in Latin America and the Caribbean have been fully vaccinated, adding that the figure obscures the fact that some countries, including Honduras and Haiti, have yet to reach even 1% inoculation. So she reiterated a call for countries with enough doses to distribute them as quickly as possible to needy countries. And they clearly need more vaccines, and they need them now, she said. Also, the COVAX mechanism will send 3.7 million more vaccine doses to countries in the Americas region through the end of July. And PAHO is working closely with the United States to overcome logistical challenges for delivery of donations, right? So on Tuesday, 3 million doses of the Moderna coronavirus vaccine donated by the U.S. arrived in Guatemala, bringing the 4.5 million bringing to 4.5 million the number of doses the U.S. has sent the Central American nation. Now, the Americas reported 967,000 new cases and 22,000 deaths last week. And Etienne said a slight weekly decrease, but these trends illustrate how the coronavirus remains entrenched within the region, right? So in the U.S., meanwhile, there is concern over persistent vaccine hesitancy in some parts of the country, as well as fears over breakthrough cases among vaccinated people. Just more than 68% of adults in the U.S. have received at least one jab, but several states have reached the 40% or more mark. The state of Mississippi ranks last with only 37.7% of adults having received at least one dose, and officials are blaming misinformation on social media, and in recent weeks have stepped up efforts to address the issue. So that's the first news item. The second news item is about another thing in America. This is about America, the U.S., about monkeypox. I've never heard of this until now, but more than 200 contacts are tracked in the U.S. for this rare disease. More than 200 people in 27 U.S. states are being tracked for possible rare monkeypox infections, health officials are saying. They fear people may have come into contact with a Texas man who brought the disease in from Nigeria earlier this month. And the man, believed to be the first monkeypox case in the U.S. since 2003, was taken to hospital but is in stable condition. But so far, no new cases have been found. And the CDC says it is concerned passengers who were on board two flights the man made have been exposed to the disease. He flew into Atlanta, Georgia from Lagos, Nigeria on July 9th before taking a flight to Dallas, where he was hospitalized, the CDC said. Now, it said it was working with the airlines to assess potential risks to those who may have had close contact with the traveler, but the chances of the disease spreading on the plane were low because passengers had to wear face masks, it added. So a CDC spokesperson told the BBC it was working with state and local health departments to follow up with individuals who may have been exposed to monkeypox, right? So monkeypox is like a rare viral disease from the same family as smallpox, but is much less severe, thank God, and occurs mostly in remote parts of Central and West African countries near the tropical rainforest. And the symptoms are like, you know, fever, headaches, swellings, back pain, ache muscles, you know, general, you know, listlessness, right? And once the fever breaks, a rash can develop, often beginning on the face, then spreading to other parts of the body, and most commonly the palms of the hands and soles of the feet. And the rash, which can be extremely itchy, changes and goes through different stages before finally forming a scab, which later falls off, and the lesions can cause scarring, but most cases of the virus are mild, sometimes resembling chickenpox, and clear up on their own within a few weeks. So monkeypox can sometimes be more severe, however, with 1 in 100 cases being deadly, according to the CDC. Though rare, the disease has been discovered in the U.S. before. A 2003 outbreak caused 47 confirmed or probable cases and was linked to rats flown into the country. Last on the news, we have Olympics. So the Tokyo 2020 chief does not rule out canceling the games. So it's starting today, guys, right? The head of the Tokyo 2020 organizing committee has not ruled out canceling the Olympic Games. His name is Toshiro Muto, said he would keep an eye on infection numbers and hold discussions if necessary. More than 70 people associated with the games have tested positive ahead of Friday's opening ceremony. His comments came on the same day the IOC president Thomas Bach said cancellation was never an option. Now, earlier this month, Japan announced the games would go ahead in empty stadiums despite growing concern over the COVID situation. And they said they're going to continually discuss. And if there is a spike in cases, Mr. Muto's said that they'll continue to discuss, and canceling is still on the table, right? It's still on the table, right? Even during this late stage. So although the games don't officially begin until today, the sporting action has kicked off with the women's softball and football competition starting on Wednesday. So we'll get some news on that during the sports too. So like I said, only so far a total of 71 people accredited for the Tokyo Olympics have now tested positive for the virus. The 2020 Olympics and Paralympics were postponed for a year due to the coronavirus, and this is the first delay of the Olympics in the 124-year modern history of the Games. So the opening ceremony of the Olympic Games is due to be held on July 23rd, though the first event of the Games, softball, between Japan and Australia, took place on Wednesday. The Olympics will end on August 8th, with the Paralympic Games due to start on August 24th and to end on September 5th, right? But of course, as we've heard before, there is much public anger over the coronavirus restrictions, and people in Japan are also concerned about the influx of tens of thousands of people associated with the event and the impact they could have on infection rates, right? So even right now, host city Tokyo, facing fresh surge of infections with 1,387 cases recorded just on Tuesday, and Japan is currently under a state of emergency, which will be in place until August 22nd, right? So let's pray and make sure that nothing serious happens over there too. All right, so that is the three top news. We're going to go into some sporting news. Let's just start off with the Olympics. The Olympics started from Wednesday. There was softball and soccer action going on, and some surprising news is the world champions, the U.S., lost their opening match to Sweden at the Olympic Games. The world champions were stunned, and they lost 3-0 in Tokyo, with striker Stina Blackstenius scoring twice before substitute Lena Hurdig added a third for Sweden, and it ended a run of 44 straight unbeaten games for the U.S. coming into the Olympics. So secondly, we're going to take a look at the softball action. Canada versus the U.S. Yes, I was excited until I saw the score. And Monica Abbott, the pitcher for the U.S., she pitched a one-hitter, and center fielder Haley McClenney and second baseman Ali Aguilar combined to throw out the potential tying run at the plate in the sixth inning. And the United States beat Canada 1-0 on Thursday for a 2-0 start. Abbott struck out 9, walked 3, and needed 102 pitches to throw the Americans' second consecutive one-hitter. And Kat Osterman, she's 38, is the American senior player, struck out 9 over 6 innings, and Abbott struck out the side in the 7th to finish an opening 2-0 win over Italy on Wednesday. Yeah. So yes, they beat Canada. Yes, they beat Canada. It makes me a little bit upset. But either way, last but not least, we'll go to boxing news. Canelo Alvarez is going to make history if he's got another amazing match coming up, and he's going to be facing Caleb Plant. Now, Tuesday brought news that Canelo Alvarez, who holds 3 of the world titles at super middleweight, is finalizing plans for a title unification fight against IBF world title holder Caleb Plant in September. If he defeats Plant, right? Canelo Alvarez, only 31 years old, will have won all 4 belts at 168 pounds within a 9-month stretch. That is crazy, guys. In 9 months, he's won 3 belts in 9 months or eight months. And then next month or in 2 months later, he's going to win if he wins that one, it's going to be the 4th month. And can you believe that? 9 months, 4 titles? That's crazy. Of course, everyone knows that he has this $300 million contract with this promotion, the internet promotion called DAZN. It broadcasts boxing over the internet, but they signed him for over $300 million for 10 fights. And he's going to have, like, he's got 4 or 5 already just this over the last 9 months. And then even before that, he's going to be hitting that 10 mark really, really fast. So that is news, sports news for today, which means now that all the physical news is over, we got to go into our golden time. Yes, it's a time of praise and worship. What are we going to sing today? We're going to start off with Holy Spirit, I Like You, I Love You, then My Beloved is the Best, and of course, this epic song at the very end to break things down will be I Have Found My Love. So I hope that everyone here just really opens your heart and praises God with all your heart, and then let's just do this together here as one body of the Morning Star Drive.
Spirit, I like you, yes, I love you. I really love you so. That's because every time that life is hard, I know I can come and seek your help. And like a mother, you will be there.
I must go.
have found my love. What an epic song. I hope there's a part two to it that is kind of the response. That song is so good. Before that was My Beloved is the Best and Holy Spirit, I Like You, I Love You. All right, guys, so let's get into the word study for today. So what is going on? This is from the Wednesday message, What All of You Must Do Right Now. And I hope that you guys will enjoy this time of word study and kind of gets you to have more thoughts or think more deeply about this week's message. So the first thing I want to bring up is what Sunseem brings up in the very beginning is there is a reason why God is telling us this. Right, there's a reason why God is saying these, particularly these three things, and why we have to do it right now. What all of you must do, right? It's a must. It's a command. This is what we must do right now. God is telling us to do it straight away, right? And, you know, I like how Sunseem said, you know, when you're getting something done, there's never this great sense of achievement when you do it late, or a great sense of achievement when you do it after the fact, right? You got to do it when you're supposed to do it, you know? It kind of reminds me of like the stock market, because I know like Bitcoin just went up to like, shot up to like $37,000 a coin. And honestly, imagine if you were there, because when I first saw Bitcoin come out, it was at like $1,000, under $1,000, $2,000, and people were freaking out when it hit 10. It's at $37,000. Can you imagine if you did it at that time, how much, you know, you would actually have? And there's a sense of achievement then jumping in right now at 37 rather than jumping in it when it was only $500, right? So God is telling us to do it right now for a reason, and we're not going to know until we actually do it or until we actually suffer harm from it, right? So I like how this was tied into the 30 lessons when it comes to the conflict and ignorance. And I like it because he says, he talked not so much about Josiah, he talked about Nico, and he says, Nico had a dream. God told him to do something and he did it right away. He rounded up his army. He went straight to Carchemish the moment God told him to go, right? God sent him to go and fight against those that were against Israel. So then the Holy Trinity is, if you think about it, we're in the same position as Nico, as in we're in the same position where God is telling us right now, do it straight away. And the crazy part is, it was just Josiah or God. It was the very person who prayed for it, the very person who God was helping that blocked. And Josiah didn't know who the enemy was. He couldn't discern it properly, and he died by an arrow, like just a random arrow. And when we think about this, God is telling us to do something this week. And we're Nico in the sense that we have to go out and do it right away. But yet it almost feels like it's our self-centered thoughts that are coming against us like Josiah. And you can kind of tie it into the Sunday message, because he's like, to fall asleep at the wheel is to be self-centered. So it's almost like if we can't catch who God is using or when God is telling us to do something, it is when we have our self-centered thoughts and we're thinking according to ourselves instead, right? So Josiah, his problem was going to be all resolved, which means, think about this, if we have problems, they are going to be resolved. They're going to be resolved this week. We just got to put it and do it right away. Even at the time, when you think about what Josiah was doing, all the reformations that he did, that means Israel was doing really, they were on an upswing, right? They were moving up, right? And the way Sunseem put it was, they were about to meet the golden time, right? If they were able to let Egypt through, they would have been in this golden era for Israel. They would have been connected with Egypt. They would have destroyed Babylon. They would prepare, and everything would be getting ready to prepare for Jesus' coming. And the way Sunseem put it in the past, when it comes to the conflict ignorance lecture, it was Israel would be the spiritual head. Egypt would be the cultural head. And then Assyria would be like the military and the physical head, right? They would have been such a huge empire that would have been physically, mentally, like body, soul, and spirit. All of that would be perfectly ready for Jesus to come. And if you see, because of that one mistake Josiah did, what we know is instead of Jesus coming to that type of place where Israel is one of the top countries, by the time Jesus came, it was the Romans, and they were oppressed at that time, right? They weren't on top. They weren't one of the kings. They were being ruled over by the Romans instead. So you can see there would have been a huge difference. So you know, we have to understand is not only is God working to help us, but Sunseem's also saying that God's also using people you never thought, and they're going to help us too, right? And that then God will use that person that fits the purpose. God uses everyone, not just the people of God, right? And we have to realize this right now, and we have to memorize this because God is going to resolve. We're getting near to the end of the 70 days also with all these prayers. God will start to resolve all these things, right? And if we don't take action right away, we have to understand is it's like falling to your death. History is going to happen, right? The ultimate history is happening right now. But it's a matter of, are we going to center on God, not have conflict in ignorance? Are we going to do things right away when God tells us? Are we going to rely on God, right? Because that's when God is with us. Well, what do you mean God is with us only if we listen to him? Well, think about it. If the words of God is God, then when we put the words of God into action, why would he not be with us? Because he's trying to make the words come true. So if anything, God, you know, when it comes to marriage, you know, the husband and wife, they don't do things alone. They're doing things together. And that's what God wants to do with us now, even at this time. It's just too hard to do it alone. So I hope that all of us too will understand, kind of like he gave that principle of the olive tree, saying that with one person, you only have one thread can lift one apple, but two threads can lift 5 to 6. So we have to be those that are working together with our counterparts, right? And what's another part that I really liked? Oh, and I like the part when he says, you know, don't just do it. You have to put your life on the line to do it. He says, if you put your life on the line at that level, then your clothing becomes, the clothing of your spirit shines brightly, like more brighter than the sun, right? That's the clothing of love, what it looks like. And once all your love is completed, like you receive spiritual clothing. And I hope that we can do that, put our life on the line to do what God really wants from us. Now, does that mean we're going to stop eating and stop doing all these other different things? It could possibly mean that if it was necessary. But in most cases, what we see right now is a lot of the things we can get done without putting our life on the line. And when you look at this, the Confident Ignorance lecture, it says that the first attempt is always easier. It's the second attempt that's harder. And the second attempt that you really have to put your life on the line, but the first attempt is much easier. So I hope that all of us can do it completely. So I think what we need to do is really realize, more than anything else, why is God telling us this? And we'll know by the end of this week, right? This week, God was telling us to be careful, right? And Sunseem said, because we are careful and more alert to this, it means many accidents were reduced, which makes sense. And of course, you know, this is summertime, so it's hot, people fall asleep. But, you know, we're people are coming to their senses because Sunseem said, everyone be careful on your own. I'm sure Sunseem saw something in the spiritual world that could have happened. And those people that really, really thought carefully, they're saved from it, right? And I like how Sunseem said, pray, you know, pray before you drive. Pray before you go out. Pray before you play sports, because God is your insurance, right? If you put it that way, God's like your 365 days, 24/7 insurance. He is the protector and the guardian, right? And then he talked about the signature he wrote for everyone who drives too. I thought it was quite awesome that we've had that for decades already. Oh man, what about the videos of the accidents? Oh my goodness, that was so crazy. It was scary because it's real life. That was so scary. It's like, you know, anyone could die. Like after looking at those, we're like, wow. And a lot of times it wasn't like these people were, sometimes it was the road, it was rainy and slippery. And sometimes you just see people drift off. You're like, hey, why are they doing that? And you're like, no way. And it's on the freeway when everyone's traveling so fast with buses and like rigs. It was freaky. And it was true. Right when you watch that, he's like, you know, anyone could die in a second. Even if you're absolutely healthy, you can die in a second. And I was like, wow, that's crazy. And he's like, wear your seatbelt. I'm like, you better wear your seatbelt, guys. It doesn't matter if you're in the back seat. I know in Korea, Malaysia, and other countries, for some reason, they think you don't have to put your seatbelts on in the back seat. But like in America, Canada, and stuff, you have to wear it. Doesn't matter what, where. When I went to Africa, even in the passenger seat, riding shotgun, they wouldn't drive if I had my seatbelt on. It was crazy, right? So, man, we have to wear our seatbelts. God and the Holy Spirit are protecting us, right? So, oh my goodness. It was just reminding me of those videos. It was crazy. I just really pray that no one will have to go through any of that type of thing, right? And also, this is what I need to do. It's been like 5 years. Get a health checkup, right? If you need to get the operation when you need to get it done, but got to get checked up. Look after your health straight away, right? Right. So everyone, guys, we got to get our checkup. Go to Korea. If you can get a checkup, get it checked up right away. Look after yourself with fiery eyes and do it right away. So those of you guys out there, let's make sure we get checkups on that. And, you know, go out and run. So it seems like I ran this much and then I also ran with my hands and I was like, what? And he's like, you talk about pens? That was crazy. That is so amazing. If you think about that too, yeah, how much do we actually write with our hands when you're writing with a pen? Man, that was intense. For me to listen to that was really, really amazing. So I hope that everyone, we got to be healthy. Make sure that our head leaders are healthy. Go out, make sure that they're eating well too. Buy them dinner, buy them something healthy. Go out to jog and run with them also, right? And I hope that all of us here too can really, really take to heart the message that the Lord and God has given us this week and do it right away, right? We got to do it right away more than anything else. Take care of your bodies. It is the temple of God. Then your illnesses will be treated right away. So I hope that we can, you know, we can be those that are always thankful in front of God. And especially when you go into the Wonmyeongdong-san, he was like, yeah, you got to be thankful in God's temple. Then your illnesses will be healed right away. If you're thankful in front of God and you pray, then you drink the water, then you'll be healed. Right? So this is the week, problems, issues, and I think Sun seems just hinting at all the issues and problems that have been solved for him, right? And he's comparing it to Josiah and Joshua. So we have to be those that think at that level too, right? Through the word, people can come to the Duena life listening to these words. No one else can say this about the words they preach. The message of truth, what we're learning right now is so big, it is so valuable, we need to preach it, right? We need to evangelize, right? Wow, man, what a great message, right? So I think that last point that I thought was really cool was when he says, when you get scolded, learn why you are getting scolded. Right? Because if anything, we need to do it perfectly in front of God. And Jesus said this to us too in Matthew 5:48, be perfect for the Lord your God is perfect. We got to do it blamelessly in front of God. Or as what happens in those parables and the stories Jesus gave is, or possessions are given to those that are going to be faithful. So I really, really hope that that we can be those that are constantly improving ourselves, getting ourselves to the next level. Guys, we don't have much time when it comes to the last couple of days for the 70-day prayer condition. After this weekend, we're going to have like 2 weeks left. So I hope that all of us here can really spend the last 2 weeks really powerfully doing the 14-day, not the 14, the seven, the finishing off the 70-day prayer condition in the best way possible. Okay? So that is the word study for today. I hope you guys really enjoyed it, which means it is going to be the song of choice for today. Now, today's song of choice, it is Musical Friday. However, I am not going to play a musical. Why? Because there is a request all the way over there in Minnesota. Minnesota in the U.S. of A. This is from Chris Jansen. Good buddy, good guy, blessed family. He was in the New York church. He came visit a lot when I was head leading there. Great guy. And he just introduced me to a new group called London Grammar. Never heard of them. Great music, though. This song is called Intro. Right? The visual, something about visualization video, something along that line, but it's from London Grammar. First time I ever heard this group, really good, and the song is called Intros. I hope that you guys will really enjoy. Thank you. And there you go. That is Request for the Week. That is London Grammar with the song Intro. This is from Chris Jansen all the way over there in the US. Hope you guys really enjoyed that. Go ahead, check out their, you can find them on YouTube, Spotify, all those other different audio places. So London Grammar, interesting. All right, guys. So that is the end of the song of choice for today, which means we get into the last segment for today. And of course, it is Friday, which means we're going to listen to the MBTI 16 personalities with Wonchan.
Hey guys, welcome again to MBTI with me, Wonchan. Today, we'll be finishing off our tertiary function section, and today's session is all about the ESTPs, ENTPs, FE. Let's get into it. Right, so do you guys remember ESTPs and ENTPs? Their auxiliary function is TI. And, you know, their characteristics when they're really healthy, that they display a good sense of making judgments and decisions. They're really direct and honest about their own flaws and mistakes and shortcomings. They're really willing to own problematic beliefs and understand it in depth. And they work hard to resolve flaws in their knowledge, their reasonings, their judgment. And then they really use their skills and intelligence in positive ways to solve problems. But as always, you know, we're not here to just hear the good things, but the karmic problems, the problems that maybe keep coming up, or maybe you've hit a slump and you've found yourself that you're not really healthy, and or even it's just because you're really undeveloped. These are the things that we need to see about ourselves. So in this state, that auxiliary TI for ESTPs and ENTPs, they tend to be really, they're not reliable. They don't have a reliable system for coherent, you know, and consistent decision making, and they become really careless, and create problems. And they don't learn the kind of they learn the wrong lesson from their mistakes. They also become kind of argumentative, oppositional, or they tend to intellectualize their wrong, harmful behavior. They cannot integrate new information into themselves if they have to admit they're wrong. And then they have poor learning methods and fail to really develop skills and their talents properly. So when the ESTPs and the ENTPs, they try to silence their TI, their auxiliary TI, that function, then, and, you know, they try to reject it, and the need, what they're doing is they're trying to reject the need to critically assess their own judgments. Yeah, that function is helping them to do that. And so the logical consequences of failing to develop auxiliary TI is that the person cannot develop a realistic understanding of their own strengths and weaknesses due to never analyzing how they got it wrong. So instead of addressing the problem directly, those who are immature, they start to misuse their tertiary extroverted feeling, FE, to distance themselves from that problem. So they just jump over, thus the FE loop, you know, starts, and they start to tend to use social perception, you know, extroverted feeling, as a foil for defining themselves. And often they try to use that to dominate relationships or even manipulate social perception to feel more confident or intellectual. And, you know, this is the loop, you know. They stop using the logic, and they just use the kind of collective to identify themselves. And tertiary, you know, extroverted feeling, you know, being that starts to, you know, reward resistance towards their second, you know, auxiliary function. And then that gives them a false sense of superiority, and that provides a convenient excuse to dismiss any personal flaws that they might have. And remember, guys, like, you're not always aware that you're within this loop, or, you know, whoever you may know. They probably don't know, because it's not easy to analyze yourself within that space of mind and see yourself correctly. So you need that objective feedback so that you can check yourself and have someone deal with that stubbornness that's definitely going to come, and defensiveness and self-inflicted all those self-inflicted problems that, you know, that you might be able to see within the person or someone might see within you. So having that person close by is useful, someone that you could trust and give that objectiveness. So there's, you know, these are the problems that you might see within yourself when you're stuck in this extroverted feeling loop as an ESTP or ENTP. So you can't admit your wrong thoughts or, you know, judgments, even though it's causing you bad outcomes. And you have difficulty being resolute without receiving external help or validation. And use humor to deflect any attention from your shortcomings. And you start fishing for praise or agreement or affirmation to deflect any criticism. And you want to be taken seriously, but then when it comes down to it, the situation, you're not actually serious. And you start citing kind of expert facts rather than looking at the truth. And you make unfair, condescending social comparisons to feel superior over others. And then you provoke or you manipulate people's emotions for your own agenda. Wow. So when you, you know, really put that concerted effort into working on yourself and making yourself mature, those cognitive functions, right? You know, TI, as an ESTP or ENTP, TI as your auxiliary function, that second function, that co-driver, and that tertiary function. Once you really balance them and have them well-rounded and polished through development, you will feel that warm, generous, considerate, cooperative, affectionate ability so that you feel, yeah, you start to feel that genuine self-confidence building within yourselves. And, you know, by using those skills and remaining positive, and you will actually develop ability to have lasting contribution, you know, to everything that you put your hand to. So everyone, yeah, especially ESTP, ENTPs, I hope that you can work on yourselves. And, you know, once we really pull out the weeds, we're really able to grow properly. So look at yourselves and find the weaknesses and identify them. It's not easy to make ourselves right, but yeah, let's realize and change. So see you guys next week. Hope you have listened to the message well, put it to practice, and let's do it together. All right, see you guys. Bye.
And there you go. Another awesome episode from Wan Chun over there in Canada. That is the MBTI 16 personalities. Hope you guys really enjoyed it. More than enjoying it, though, is kind of realizing about yourselves and developing yourselves even more, knowing what kind of character you have. All right, guys, that was it. That was the last segment, not only for today's Friday podcast, but for the entire week. Hope you guys really have an amazing weekend. Guys, enjoy the Sunday edition we have with, who is it this week? It is Rose Lederman over there in Texas. Have an amazing weekend. Then we'll see you guys again on Monday on the Morningstar Drive on 117.8.
It's the Morningstar Drive 117.8. You soaring up with sky, now's the time, don't delay. I'm sitting in my ride and it's time to fly. So let's realign, just listen and fill your mind.
I'm burning with desire and the passion. Nobody can stop me when I'm like this. I got my head in the zone, you know. I'm on the Morningstar Drive.